Hi, welcome to Nagesh Biology online classes. Those who have not subscribed to my channel, please subscribe to get newly uploading videos. Last major event of the cell cycle, that is cytokinesis, division of cytoplasm is called, that is cytokinesis. But cytokinesis process, it will be different in animal cells and as well as plant cells. How cytokinesis process occurs in animal cells and as well as plant cells, that will discuss detailed information. First, in animal cells, how cytokinesis process occurs. In animal cells, at the end of the telophase, it will observe one single cell consists of two nuclei. Now here each chromosome has one chromatid only. Entire one nucleus has four chromosomes, four DNAs. Now animal cell, the mechanism of the cytokinesis, that is called cell furrow method. That is otherwise known as groove method. How cell furrow method occurs in animal cells? At the time of cytokinesis, from this plasma membrane, it forms a constriction. Constriction, nothing but a inward folding. That's why it is also called constriction method. There are different names are there for cytokinesis process in animal cells. Cell furrow method, or cell groove method, or constriction method. During this process, a constriction will form. Just inward folding, plasma membrane it fold, and both sides at a time it fold, and the constrictions are formed both ends. That constriction extend at center of the cell. Once look at the board, but arrow mark I am showing direction like this. The cell membrane extending from peripheral to center. Finally, the both sides, so constrictions, they connect with each other. It leads to formation of a plasma membrane that ultimately leads to formation of two daughter cells. But here the constriction, it deepens from peripheral to central. The formation of constriction, that is centripetal development. Centripetal development means peripheral to center. That membrane development will be from peripheral to center. Like this, cell furrow method of cytokinesis occurs in animal cells. How cytokinesis process occurs in plant cells? Now, because plant cells cytokinesis process different from animal cells, because plant cells, they have outer boundary wall is cell wall. Now once we'll discuss the cytokinesis process in plant cells. Here both sides, chromosomes, four chromosomes are there. Nuclear membrane already appeared in telophase. Nucleolus, cell organelles, everything will be there, because telophase cell only enters into the cytokinesis, that is in plant cells or animal cells. But in the plant cells, the formation, that method is called cell plate method. The mechanism of cell wall formation in plant cells, that is cell plate method. The first spindle fibers in a anaphase, at the end of the telophase, all the spindle fibers, they becomes into the small fragments. The spindle fibers only help to pulling of the chromosomes or movement of the chromosomes, but all the chromosomes are migrated to opposite poles, nuclear envelope is reappeared. But even though some spindle fibers will be there at center of the cell, these spindle fibers, all fragments, the remnant of spindle fibers, remaining small fragments of spindle fibers will form a special structure that is called phragmoplast. Now here, spindle fibers, remnant of spindle fibers. So here the spindle fibers, small fragments are there like this. All these fragments helps to form a special barrel shaped structure that is known as phragmoplast. This is a barrel shaped structure. All these spindle fibers, small fragments of the spindle fibers, help to form a special barrel shaped structure that is called phragmoplast. This is the structure of phragmoplast. After formation of phragmoplast, Golgi complex, it is a cell organelle that helps to production of chemicals calcium and magnesium pectates. Calcium and magnesium pectates are produced by Golgi complex cell organelle. These chemicals, they act on phragmoplast. Because of that, all the fragments of the phragmoplast, the phragmoplast, it consists of small fragments of the spindle fibers. All these, they dissolve and form a special layer, special structure. Like this structure, that is known as cell plate. This phragmoplast becomes into cell plate. Cell plate converts into middle lamellum. It is a layer of cell wall. So here, once you see, all spindle fibers will form phragmoplast. Phragmoplast develops into cell plate. Cell plate develops into middle lamellum. Middle lamellum, it is part of cell wall. First formed layer of the cell wall, that is middle lamellum. In exam, what type of questions you can expect? Middle lamellum formed from cell plate. Cell plate is formed from phragmoplast. Phragmoplasts are formed from the remnant of spindle fibers, that is fragments of spindle fibers. So like this, the total development takes place. All these major events, whatever occurs in the plant cell, we'll observe. First, all remnants of spindle fibers, they reach us to cell, at the center of the cell. So all these remnants of spindle fibers converts into barrel shaped structure. Like this structure, that is formed from remnant of spindle fibers. This is phragmoplast. Because of Golgi complex chemicals, that is calcium and magnesium pectates, this phragmoplast, slowly it melts and forms a cell plate. Cell plate is formed from phragmoplast. This cell plate, it extends both sides up to this layer, up to this layer. It will extend like this. Finally, it converts into middle lamellum. Middle lamellum, it is first formed layer of the cell wall. The precursor of middle lamellum. Middle lamellum precursor means from where it is formed. Cell plate. Precursor means previous form, previous structure, or before structure. Precursor of middle lamellum means that is cell plate. Precursor of cell plate means phragmoplast. Precursor of phragmoplast means that is spindle fibers. So spindle fibers, the fragments of spindle fibers also play important role in plant cells indirectly for the formation of middle lamellum. Like this, total the cytokinesis process occurs. But after karyokinesis only cytokinesis process occurs. If cytokinesis do not occur in the cell, one cell consists of two nuclei. Those two nuclei, again if they enters into the one more karyokinesis division, repeatedly karyokinesis occurs in the cell, that leads to appearance of many nuclei in one single cell. That condition is called cenocytic condition. Now let me explain here the concept. Here one single cell is there. That cell has first two nuclei formed, but cytokinesis not occurred in the cell. Free nuclear division. If only nucleus divides, that division is called free nuclear division. These two nuclei again help to form four nuclei. These four nuclei again help to form eight nuclei. Like this, the nuclei divides and produces more number of nuclei within one single cell, but the cytokinesis not occurred in the cell. It is only one single cell but having many nuclei. Due to failure of cytokinesis in this cell, but karyokinesis continuously occurred, this condition is called multinucleatic condition, or this is otherwise known as syncytium. This condition otherwise known as cenocytic condition. So here easy to remember all these terms. Just MSc, Master of Science course is there. MSc, M for multinucleatic condition, S for syncytium, C for cenocytic condition. So the best example for cenocytic condition, best example here, coconut water, that is you can observe inside the coconut. The total coconut water, coconut milk, that is formed because of free nuclear division. That is cenocytic condition can be seen in coconut. Scientific name, Coccus nucifera. So here whatever coconut water we can observe, that is liquid endosperm that acts like coconut water, that we can call it as coconut milk. So whatever coconut water we drink that is consisting only nuclei, free nuclear division effect, many nuclei will be there in the coconut water. Liquid endosperm coconut water, that is a triploid in nature. Endosperm, it is a triploid tissue, but all nuclei will be in the 3N condition. So that is due to free nuclear division, but cytokinesis not occurred here in the liquid endosperm of coconut. That is the best example for multinucleatic condition. If the cell consists of more than two nuclei, that we can call it as multinucleatic condition. If one cell consists of one single nucleus, eukaryotic or monokaryotic condition. If the one single cell consists of two nuclei, that is a bikaryotic condition or dikaryotic condition. More than two nuclei, any cell consists, that condition we can call it as multinucleatic condition.